United as one body of Christ, we gather in our homes and here at St. Denis Catholic Church to celebrate the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. For those sitting in our courtyard, please wear your face covering throughout the Mass and maintain social distancing, at least 6 feet of separation between people from different households. Please note that Holy Communion will be distributed in the courtyard at the end of Mass rather than at the usual time. The restrooms are in the hall, which is behind you. Donations may be dropped off in one of the locked boxes in the courtyard. This Mass is being live streamed via our Facebook page, and a video of the Mass will be uploaded shortly thereafter to our YouTube channel. To help those at home to participate, there is a worship aid on our website. Just go to our website, stdenis.org, and scroll down and click on the worship aid. In addition, you can type in your prayer intentions into the comments section on Facebook or YouTube, because during the universal prayer, we will lift up to the Lord all of the prayers in the comments section. Thank you. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome everyone to this Mass here at St. Denis as we celebrate on this, the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let's first acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord, my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I'm a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made this request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding, so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will come no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Lord, I love your commands.
Lord, I love your commands.
I have said, O Lord, that my part is to keep your words. The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Lord, I love your commands.
Let your kindness comfort me, according to your promise to your servants. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight.
Lord, I love your commands.
For I love your commands more than gold, however fine. For in all your precepts I go forward, every false way I hate.
Lord, I love your commands.
Wonderful are your decrees, therefore I observe them. The revelation of your words sheds light, giving understanding to the simple.
Lord, I love your commands.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it." The Gospel of the Lord. In today's gospel, Jesus uses two parables to describe the kingdom of heaven. In the first parable, a person finds a treasure buried in a field, and he goes and sells all that he has to buy the field in order to possess the buried treasure, which represents the kingdom of heaven. In the second parable, a merchant finds a pearl of great price, and he goes and sells all that he has to buy that pearl, which likewise represents the kingdom of heaven. Thus, the people in these parables are willing to sacrifice everything for the heavenly kingdom. And what about us? Are we willing to sacrifice everything for heaven? According to Jesus in today's gospel, we not only should sacrifice everything, but we must sacrifice everything for the kingdom of heaven. And heaven isn't some place high above the clouds with angels playing harps. Rather, heaven is all of God's people entering into the inner life of God. That is, entering into the loving relationship of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, with everyone loving everyone else to the maximum possible extent. Indeed, because God is love, heaven is unending, mutually unconditional love. And so, the kingdom of heaven is beyond our wildest dreams. That's why Jesus indicates that we have to sacrifice and give everything for it. And Jesus himself has shown us the way to heaven. He has taught that we have to love God with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. That is, with our whole being. And that we have to love our neighbor as we love ourselves. That's how Jesus lived his life. He loved God and neighbor passionately and unreservedly. Consequently, he gave all that he had and sacrificed everything, including his very life, for God and for us. And Jesus invites us to live our lives in the same passionate way, by giving our all and holding nothing back. Just as the people in the gospel parables sold all that they had to buy the field with the buried treasure and the pearl of great price, we must sacrifice everything and offer all that we have in loving service to God and our neighbor. One thing that we have to sacrifice and give up is selfishness, because there's no room for selfishness and self-centeredness in the kingdom of heaven. Thus, we need to give up our pride, our anger, our lust, and we need to give up our desire for money, for power and success. We need to give up all of these selfish things and take the time and energy that we devote to them and redirect that time and energy to loving God and loving our neighbor fully and completely, just as Jesus did. This means that we have to completely change our approach to life. Instead of going around and asking ourselves, what's in it for me? Or how can I benefit from this situation or this person? We need to reorient our lives and ask ourselves, how can I help this person or that person? Or how can I make the world a better place? Imagine how much better the world would be if everyone focused on making the world a better place rather than exploiting opportunities for selfish reasons. And frankly, we don't have to wait for everyone else to get on board in order to start changing our world. Our world will change for the better as soon as we approach life with a loving, generous heart, always helping other people and trying to improve the human condition. Indeed, if we change our approach to life and focus mainly on serving God and others, we will live a much happier and fulfilling life because we will be living the way that God made us to live. And many of you are already living in this way. For example, in a good marriage, husbands and wives sacrifice their lives for each other by loving and helping each other in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, all the days of their life. Parents sacrifice their lives for their children by loving them unconditionally from infancy, through the terrible twos, through adolescence, and into adulthood, never giving up on them, even if they mess up. Priests and religious sacrifice their lives for God and his people by serving the children of God faithfully and lovingly. Indeed, any career or vocation or job that is focused on helping people rather than making money or some other form of worldly success, any such job offers us an opportunity to sacrifice our lives for the sake of others. For example, teachers, nurses, doctors, and therapists dedicate their lives to helping those they serve. Police officers, firefighters, and those in the armed services put their lives on the line every day to help, protect, and serve others. Even some lawyers and accountants and other professionals dedicate their lives to helping the needy. And those in service-oriented jobs such as sales clerks, janitors, housekeepers, and cooks also can dedicate their lives to helping others and making their part of the world a better place. Today's gospel invites us to consider whether we are sacrificing and giving all that we have, including our lives, for the right things. If we are sacrificing our lives to love and serve God and other people fully and completely, then we are on the right track. The track that leads us from this life on earth to eternal life in heaven with the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. And now let us profess our faith using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Striving to bear witness to God's kingdom, we offer our prayers and petitions to the Father.
For the Church, may we cast a wide net as we proclaim the gospel to all peoples and nations. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may they govern with wisdom so that the world may enjoy justice and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are working to defeat coronavirus, may God give strength to all healthcare workers, insight to those researching vaccines and cures, and patience to all who face daily challenges because of the disease. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us who are gathered here, may we know the will of God and have the strength to do it. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, including Howie Powers, Linda Shaw, Rosie Grotto, Josie Matricia, Trudy Gell, Mary Lee Ramsey, and Evelyn Bistro, may God ease their suffering and restore their health. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, including Norma Estaquio, Concepcion Anchera Dario, Fredesvita Ramos, Howard Roxas, Paul Duran, Bernardo Aluning, may they be welcome into the kingdom of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who need our prayers, and for all the prayer intentions that are listed in the comment sections of Facebook and YouTube for this Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, please hear and answer our prayers through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
At this point of the Mass, we usually take up the collection. However, because of the social distancing, we can't do that today. Instead, you may drop off your donation in one of the donation boxes in the courtyard as you arrived, or you can drop off your donation in one of these boxes as you leave. Alternatively, you can support St. Denis through online giving by going to our giving page, stdenis.org/giving. This web page also listed in the worship guide aid. Thank you so much for supporting St. Denis.
Remain in me. shall have life. You are the branches, bear fruit for all to see. I am the vine, remain in me.
No branch can live without the tree, nor grow or serve apart from me. This I have told you, that you may see my love in you, your joy complete.
Remain in me, I am the vine. Remain in me, you shall.
Please stand. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth, he brought renewal out of humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering, canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy,
holy.
Holy. Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us,
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For all of those watching and participating in this Mass from home, let us pray the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. And for those of you in the courtyard, we will bring communion out to you at the end of the Mass. And when we distribute communion in the courtyard, instead of having the one-on-one dialogue that we usually have when distributing communion, we will do that dialogue all together right now. I will raise the Eucharist and say the body of Christ, and everyone can respond, Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen. Amen.
And let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated for the announcements. Thank you, everyone, for joining us for Mass today, either at home or in the courtyard. Please join us again for Mass next Sunday or during the week. All seating in our courtyard is on a first-come, first-served basis, and no reservations or tickets are needed. Please note that the chairs in the courtyard are cleaned after every Mass, and you may bring your own chair or seat cushion with you. Monday through Saturday, we celebrate an 8 a.m. Mass every morning. These Masses also are live streamed, and afterward, we offer confession in the courtyard. In addition, on Friday, we celebrate a 7 p.m. Mass, followed by a holy hour, which is also live streamed. For Sunday, we celebrate 6 Masses. A vigil Mass on Saturday at 5:30 p.m., and Masses on Sunday at 7 a.m., 9 a.m., 11 a.m., 1 p.m., and 5:30 p.m. The 11 a.m. and 5:30 p.m. Masses are also live streamed. In addition, every weeknight at 7 p.m., Monday through Thursday, please join the priests and deacons for our series that we're calling Zooming at St. Denis. Each of these weeknights at 7 p.m., a priest or deacon leads parishioners in prayer or faith formation via Zoom. For more information about everything that's happening at St. Denis, please check our website, stdenis.org. And if you need help with anything, please call the pastoral office. Finally, on your way out, for those of you in the courtyard, please drop off your donation in one of the collection boxes if you haven't already done so. We're glad that all of you are here today. We hope that you have a very blessed and happy week ahead. And now I'd like to have a sad duty to mention that Father Vincent will be returning to India. He's been with us for 5 years here at St. Denis as an associate pastor and has completed his term. And tomorrow he will be leaving for India, and he has some words for you, I believe.
Good evening to you, my dear brothers and sisters. This is the day that I need to express my gratitude and say goodbye to you all. As Father John mentioned, I completed my 5 years term in this month, that is 30th July. I have to leave the country by 30th, and tomorrow I am going back to India. At this juncture, I would like to thank each and every one of you belonging to this parish or whoever made use of this parish for anything, maybe for quinceanera, wedding, or mass. I would like to thank each and every one of you. You are all so good to me. You all accepted me as I am. Consider me as one among you. You have not or you have never shown any indifference. For that, I express my heartfelt thanks to you. This is possible through the pastors here who have worked. At this juncture, I would like to thank Monsignor Jim Lakne, who has passed away last year, maybe for his guidance and his acceptance of me, and he is now no more, but still I am very much thankful to him. Then comes Father John, after his passing away, took charge as the administrator. A new priest, newly came priest. Somehow you found out that I come from, of course he knows from India, but that I help the poor and orphan children, and I come from a poor background, family background. Last year he invited you to help me for this noble purpose. Through this I can understand how he is kind and concerned towards the poor and the needy. For his call, so many of you came forward, generously supporting that noble purpose of helping. For this, I gratefully thank Father John for his invitation towards the poor and needy. Thank you very much, Father John.
Thank you, Father Vincent.
And then I would like to thank at this juncture with whomever I worked, that is Father Save, who is now in San Jose, and then Father Mai, and then comes Father Denis. For this month, in this month, he completes 1 year. You know him very well, better than both Father John and myself, because he had worked before 5 years. You know me, know him very well, how he is a kind person, approachable person, sociable person, welcoming each and every one of you early in the morning for the mass, as well as when you go, saying goodbye, wishing you good night and whatever it is. He is very, very kind and good person, nice person, who goes out of his way whenever his help is asked for. So I would like to thank Father Denis also at this time. Thank you, Father Denis. And then I would like to thank all the deacons by name, Deacon Denis, Deacon Al, Deacon Phil, and Deacon Tom. They too have cooperated with me, accepted me as I am. I would like to thank them all. I take this opportunity to say one more word. In these 5 years, my dear brothers and sisters, especially now, I would like to thank, express my concern towards priests, either for John or for Denis or deacons. If I have done any mistake, or if I have offended you or hurt you, knowingly or unknowingly, I would like to ask pardon and forgiveness. For John, for Denis, knowingly or unknowingly, if I hurt you, please forgive. Also, my dear brothers and sisters, to you, I ask my pardon and forgiveness if I have hurt you in any way, knowingly or unknowingly, by words or actions. Please kindly forgive me and pardon me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Father Vincent. We have a special prayer for you as you prepare to travel tomorrow back to India. So for everyone at home, everyone in the courtyard, I invite you to raise your hands in Father Vincent's direction as we pray together. Heavenly Father, 5 years ago you blessed St. Denis with Father Vincent, who traveled from the other side of the world to serve us here in Diamond Bar. Thank you for Father Vincent and for his priestly ministry. Thank you for his goodness and kindness and faithfulness. Please bless and protect him as he returns home. Keep him safe from all harm and always wrapped in the mantle of your protection. And please send your Holy Spirit down upon him to lead and guide and help him in all things. We ask all of this in Jesus' holy name, amen. For those of you in the courtyard, Father Vincent will come out there and be at a table at the far side of the courtyard to greet you and say his goodbyes. There are also some cards on the table next to it, blank cards that you can fill in and write your wishes on there, and put the card in the envelope and drop it off in the basket right there. So please, if you're in the courtyard, stay a little after we distribute communion and say so long and goodbye to Father Vincent. For those of you at home, Father Vincent is featured on the toward the top of the website. He has a message for all of us and a prayer. So please check out the website, stdenis.org. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Of grace, mystery of faith, calling us to venture to the deep. Though our senses fail, your graces still prevail, and we become the love that we receive.
Here with you, oh, let us rise.